Good morning. I am from Pisa. You know, if you said something similar in Tuscany. Yeah. Any case, the presentation I want to propose to you this morning is something regarding the not the history of volcanology, so the history of the ideas inside this discipline, but the use of the historical data about volcanoes for reconstructing the volcanic history. The topic is very, very famous, is the eruption, the effects of the eruption of the 79 eruption of Vesuvius, and but not what happened in Neapolitan coast for the phenomenologies expressed by Vesuvius at that time. Instead, that what was the morphology of the volcano before the eruption is a topic that in Italy has been developed starting from the 18th century without any big success. And now we attempted to produce a new synthesis using not only volcanological data or not only historical documents, but confronting, using both together, and as generally happens when things are in deep analyzed, they converge versus something that maybe is something true or similar to the truth. The historical sources we have in the case of the Vesuvius 79 eruption, of the state of Vesuvius during and before the 79 eruptions are few and well known. The epigram of Martial, the letters of Pliny the Younger, some epigraphs, some frescoes found in Pompeii and Herculaneum, two of the city destroyed by the volcano, because they was on foot of the volcano near the sea, and the volcanological part, that is the deposit typology and distribution. Is possible to see. For making all together, we have to give some basic information about the volcanic activity during a previous time. Starting from the younger eruption that is unusual for geology, we have a period of activity that is the last one, a well-known period of Vesuvius activity with a number of eruption and of description. A medieval Vesuvius activity that widespread on the coast, along the coast essentially, lava flow emitted by eccentric event near the coast, one sub-Plinian major eruption, and the two major important Plinian eruption in the recent history of Vesuvius, that are the 79 and the Avellino one, that date at the 4,000 year, more or less of 1,000 year ago. They are divided, they represent all that what is depicted in this sketch, and their deposits are widespread in the southern portion of the volcano, while the ancient most activity of Vesuvius volcano is visible today, expressed by the deposits outcropping along this Monte Somma cliff, that is this one. the important thing for this presentation is that these deposits have an importance also in this story, because they are related to different volcanic centers that built up the volcanic morphology before the eruption of 79. So there is, in particular, you can see there is a large volcano. This is a sketch from another publication that is not the Vesuvius, but is perfect. It perfectly fit the Vesuvius situation. So this is a more ancient volcano that corresponds to the green deposit, dark green deposits here. This is not really a volcano, but is an accumulation of post-glacial deposits inside the Monte Somma steep wall, that is the two. And then we have the grow of the Cognoli di Levante, that is this portion of the Monte Somma cliff volcano in the easternmost portion of the present Vesuvius. Taking in mind this few point, you can we can reconstruct the morphological element interesting for our story. So, a caldera collapse that occurred 20,000 years ago, the Greenwich Pumice eruption, and that produced this portion of the Monte Somma cliff, at least this, maybe more, but at least this portion. A caldera collapse that is related to the Mercato Pumices eruption at 8,900 years ago, that produced another caldera collapse inside the Cognoli di Levante volcano, that is the brownish body here. And a sector collapse, that means that a portion of the volcanoes folded down directionally, so on the sea in this case, that is one of the first effects of the Avellino eruption. Then inside this depression, a tough cone has been built by the last phases of this eruption. So this is the volcanological picture that have a morphological effects on the morphology of the Vesuvius. You can see that is not a cone affected by volcanic eruption, is a number of morphological elements. Some of these elements are still well visible today. This is the tough cone of Avellino. This is a slope map. Tectonically controlled with all these deposits that are not interesting for you, but is the manner in which we have reconstructed these bodies and these structures, the stratigraphy of the volcano. And these elements, geological elements, we can mix with the historical ones. This is the famous text of Marziale, and for us is interesting for two elements, because he speak about vineyards and he speak about Bacco. For these two elements, and this describing that the Vesuvius was so nice before and now is a devastation of sand and the pumices. But the important things, these two important things, has been reprised and used for the attribution to the Vesuvius picture before the 79 eruption in this fresco, that is the Casa del Centenario fresco found in Pompeii, in which you can see Bacco and the vineyards, no? And so for this reason, people said, ah, this is the Vesuvius before 79. Actually, this has been found in Pompeii. Pompeii is from the south east of the Vesuvius, from here, this Pompeii is here. And the morphology of Vesuvius, you can see from this point of view, is very different than this one. That is from the other and perfectly fitting the panorama from Naples. So there is something not clear, that is not perfectly clear, but this is the idea that we had up to this work, up to now, of the Vesuvius before 79. But if you look more attentively this this picture, you can see, and someone have seen, and was Mr. Virginio Catalano, and no personage people in the Vesuvius literature, that wrote in the 76, that at the summit of Vesuvius, not really at the summit, but it's in this fresco, this is the reproduction of the fresco that he made, there is an ancient gigantic crater of explosion over a kilometer in diameter in the form of a number 8. So this is the perfect definition of what is the tough cone of Avellino Pamisis, with inside two other little craters that has been attributed because of the distribution of the deposits and so on, to the two unique eruption, explosive eruption that are between Avellino and the 79 eruption. So this is a very precise use of a picture of a fresco that was before considered in a superficial, if you can say that, manner. The staff cone is well visible and was well better visible before, when the number of houses was not so high. But now, this is a photograph, an ancient photograph, one of the first one of Vesuvius, took by Luigi Palmieri after the eruption of 1862. And this is showing the board, the rim of the crater, of the tough cone. Now there is the grand cone, the main cone of the Vesuvius edifice in distance. And this is the fracture of the 1871 in eruption. That now is a sequence of apartments. Why? The eruption of 79 have to be changed, this morphology we summary described. Why this eruption make Vesuvius different than was before? This is because of the phenomenology that has been expressed during the eruption. You know there is an earthquake, a big earthquake before the eruption that is assumed as the true precursor of the eruption in 62 before Christ of the current era. And the Vesuvius started with the famous pine. The column, the Plinian column, Plinian because of Plinius, column that is described as the first, the volcanological description, the birth of the volcanology. Actually, the fallout phase of Vesuvius don't modificated nothing in the morphology of Vesuvius, if not the summit crater. And during this phase, many sarge deposits has been produced. So flow deposits, high energy flow deposits that derived by the collapse of the Plinian column, and that had this effect. So the first death in this eruption has been caused by the arrival of the sarges. This is in Pompeii, Porta Marina in Pompeii. This is the fallout. Yeah? This is the fallout. This is a very old photograph. when the fallout was very well exposed. And these are the other episodes, the relevant liars, are the other Sarge's episodes that produced other destruction. But destruction, yes, but morphological modification, no. The morphological changes start with the pyroclastic flow and the debris flow phase that invested the coast, and especially Herculaneum. This is a photo that I have to put on, but I don't agree actually with exposing the poor dead people, always to be seen by everyone, only because there has been death by an eruption. And this kind of deposits made 20 meters of deposits in a big portion of the coast around Vesuvius. The other morphological element has been the caldera collapse. The caldera collapse that is perfectly described by Pliny the Younger in his letter. And is this is the phrase, the collapse of the mountain, and these are the deposits that we have found that is a block and block pyroclastic flow that contain the portion of the volcano that collapsed and has been thrown out of the vent. So at this point, we have the complete picture of the product and of the morphological effect of the Vesuvius 79 eruption. In this very famous sketch made by Sigurdsson and co-workers in 1885, you can see that the red portion that depicted are the pyroclastic flow, and there is something strange. So if the volcano was a cone, this distribution is not explained, because you have a large portion that in which there are not these deposits that flow on the ground, so are morphologically controlled. And there is another true in the distribution here. This fact can be explained by using the morphological elements we have seen before. So the Montezuma had the polyphased scarp that precluded the distribution of deposits on the northern side of the volcano. The debris avalanche scarp and the following tuff cone produced by the Avellino eruption have similar morphological effects. So they are an object on the road of the pyroclastic flow, and the 79 caldera collapsed. So for collapsing, have to have something to be collapsed. So an edifice, something that has been downthrown by the collapse. This fit with the distribution of pyroclastic flow in some particular directions that are the flank of the tuff cone, the intersection between the Somma scarp with the Pomici di Cognoli di Levante volcanic edifice we have seen before, and one main fault that is placed here that is very, very evident still today. Deposits distribution, events, volcanological events, the description we have from the deposits and from the history by Pliny the Younger of the eruption, and the previous morphological element on the volcano, they converge in this picture. And is still was still evident, very better evident than now, in some picture we have of the past times, that is of the disease of the 18th century. You can see here the caldera collapsed of the 79, very well depicted, very curved inside the mountain. This is the Ftaf cone. This is the new Vesuvius cone that is built up after the 79 eruption inside the true lived by the eruption. The reconstruction we made, we attempted to depict to you, putting all together, have not a proof, but a comfort with some ancient picture. Unfortunately, the better one is this one that is not a fresco, but is the reproduction of a fresco. So the true fresco is lacking. You know, when the Pompeii has been excavated, a lot of treasures has been destroyed. But a number of frescoes that was difficult to preserve has been drawn by the archaeological of the time. And this is one of this. This picture is preserved in Naples, in the Naples archive, in Archivio Storico Napoletano. And you can see the number refer to the main morphological structure as we interpreted. So the number one are the Apennines that are in distance and border the Campanian plain. And the number two is the westernmost portion of the Monte Somma that we have seen in the Centenario fresco. The number three is the Ftaf cone, Avellino Ftaf cone. This is a view from Naples and it perfectly correspond. And the number four. The number four is what was lacking. That is the Cognoli di Levante volcano, the brown one here. Without this reconstruction is something new in respect to the previous one. As I already said, a number of people. My fault. It's too much for him. The proposed reconstruction is different in some manner from the other old, such as this one from Palmieri, and more modern, that consider in some manner the volcano that is a cone and the volcano that is collapsed, following rounded, general rounded morphological depression. But we have seen that the history can be more complicated. And other attempts has been using the other frescoes that has been found in Pompeii, like this one that is very famous, is the Casa de Citarista fresco, that put in evidence one thing that unfortunately is still present in what we are doing, so the history of science, that the different disciplines don't speak each one with the other one. Because if you speak, as I have done, with an archaeologist or with a Pompeian archaeologist, Greta Stefani was the past superintendent in Pompeii area, you know that this frescoes was very well known and very reproduced mythological scenes, and the use was to use some key elements, and they have the cartoon as a basis, and they built the fresco on the basis of this. So mythological scenes that have another place of the same exposition in another place than Vesuvius, in this case is Carthago, and that have nothing to do with Vesuvius. But volcanologists of the first times was excited by the presence of something that, if you look well, actually Gaia was not allowed to do, so reproduce something that is not pertinent and that is not precisely a correct graphical reproduction too. So this is an example. Another is this, that is the Marco Lucrezio Frontone house. There are three mountains, and so each one, and this is Monte Somma, this is Vesuvio, this is a fantasy reconstruction, and there are many dubs now that Roman people reproduced actually true landform, the natural representation, but was the reconstruction ideal representation. There is also this element more. So I finish in 2 minutes with the joke. making this was impossible to go to see all the documents that we have about the Spartaco question. You know, Spartaco with his gladiators escaped from Capua to Vesuvius first, then to Nola, and first started the gladiator wars, no, that finished with his death. And in this first moment of the story, Spartacus went along the Popilia Annia, that is the consular road between Capua and Capua. He was based on Capua as a gladiator. So he started from Capua, going to south along the consular road, to Reggio Calabria, from Capua to Reggio Calabria. At Acerra, that is north of Somma Vesuviana, you can see here, he made a deviation because he had Claudius 3,000 soldier at his back and going on the mountain for attempting a place for making a resistance or having a way of escape. You can do this today, still today. I have made this path, and it's perfectly feasible in the hour that we have reconstructed by the sources. And the Roman camp, Spartacus went to the summit of Vesuvius near at the basis of the Punta del Nasone wall that is impossible to overpass. And Claudius was put the camp here. That is a place a little bit larger because of a volcanic structure, a particular volcanic structure that is here. And when he went here, the only possibility he had was to go down from the steep walls of the Monte Somma. With the use of this rope, because it's quite impossible to climb or to descend without an help, because volcanic material are very, very unstable. And if the condition was that we depicted before, he percorred this path, going back, that is perfectly easy in few hours, and going at the back of the Roman, as is described, and they was unaware of this possibility, and he gained against Claudius Glabro at this moment. And then he reprised the road for Nola, and this is important because fit with this is another piece of this reconstruction. That is a joke, I repeat, but is a joke that fit with the morphology with the reconstructed, and so we are happy of this. Thank you for the attention.
Yes. So thank you for your very nice talk about and also your critical attitude against how images are used from different point of views. And thank you for me, it was a deconstruction of the image I have from the Vesuv.
Not only for you.
Yes. I can't speak only for me. You have a canon and then it's in your brain, and you brought a lot of arguments against this canon, and thank you very much. So I think there are many questions to this very nice topic. Oh, Maddalena, please.
Thank you, Claudia, for your wonderful talk. I wanted to ask you why, in your opinion, previous volcanologists wanted to say in an obliged way the Vesuvius in this representation, in which there are just mountains and not the Vesuvius itself.
Why in this representation, why add the previous representation of only one cone?
Why people said that this was the Vesuvius, while it wasn't?
It's a good and complicated question. There is a volcanological question answer that is easy and that is not mine. The answer is not mine. It's by Henry James Johnston Lewis in 1888. He performed the stratigraphy of Monte Somma volcano, and he found that it was impossible that the Monte Somma was a circular volcano with only one vent, because the position of deposits was against this, and it was well evident that there was many vents that as a whole built a volcano, a central volcano, so called central volcano, but that don't mean a cone, no? And this is in the collective imagination, no? The normal imagination of people, volcanoes are a cone. Vesuvius is round, Monte Somma is rounded, and so it's easier to assume that this was the morphology. And this is the volcanological point of view. No one made the stratigraphy, as well as Johnston Lewis for a long period, because a number of things that are in the history of volcanology, of the development of the ideas of volcanology, in which the lavas was most important than the pyroclastics, and so on. And the other one is philosophical. It is related to the centenary fresco. The centenary fresco is the one that have guided the ideas of the Monte of the Vesuvius before the 79, because it is in Pompeii, because is like this, very similar to a portion of the volcano we can see now. And this was enough. I answer.
Thank you.